If I disappear, do not let my paintings die. These were the words of a German Jewish surrealist painter, Felix Nussbaum, who were caught under the hatred and oppression of the Nazis. With clouds of terror and fear hovering over his head, he continued his artistic journey and unapologetically portrayed his Jewish identity, even when anti-Semitism was at its peak. This video would delve into Nussbaum's cathartic paintings that he created during the time when he escaped from one of the Nazi concentration camps. In the midst of chaos, hopelessness, and death, he revealed the Nazis' inhumanity, emphasized his Jewish identity, and exhibited a ray of hope through his paintings. Nussbaum was born in 1904 in Osnabrück, Germany, a close-knitted family who believed in the phrase Germans of the Mosaic Faith, with nationality taking precedence over religion. Since childhood, Nussbaum's parents identified his knack for arts, and he was enrolled in the Berlin Academy of Arts. Soon, he received recognition and a prestigious scholarship to study in Rome in 1932. When the Nazis came into power in 1933, their policies in culture extended all the way to Rome, and painters like Nussbaum were considered degenerate artists. From here on, Nussbaum and his girlfriend Felka Pletek, whom he later married, lived a life of exile. They first fled to Italy and eventually to Belgium. A refugee living in a foreign country where their future was unpredictable and full of fear. When the Germans occupied Belgium in the 1940s, Nussbaum's fear became a reality and he was arrested by the Nazis and thrown into the concentration camp in southern France. He saw his fellow inmates succumb to death in front of his eyes. This was a shattering revelation to him, an existential threat to the entire Jewish people. Somehow, he escaped and reunited with his wife Felka in Brussels. From this point, Nussbaum's artwork began expressing melancholy, feelings of dread and persecution with a hint of fragile optimism. He lived a short life, but his body of work is profound and extensive. Self-portrait in the camp was painted in May 1940. After escaping from the internment camp at St. Cyprian, where more than 7,500 German Jews were imprisoned, he spent 4 years painting in Brussels. His friends sheltered him and Felka. In fact, one of his friends arranged a basement studio for him, concerning that the turpentine smell would reveal him to Nazi officers on Jew hunts. A man can be a human only under human conditions. This painting was a translation of his traumatic and harsh experience in the camp. He is shown imprisoned and wears a torn shirt. Behind him is a bare-assed woman defecating in a steel drum and a naked, haggard man walking by. Fear, self-portrait with niece Marianne, was created in 1941, where the world seems to be in an apocalypse. And it was an apocalypse where the Jewish lost their lives for no reason, but only that they were born as Jewish. Nussbaum and his niece feel frightened in the portrait. Portrait of Three was created in 1944 when Nussbaum painted himself as a pious Jew, wearing a talit and a kippah and the presence of a yellow badge, asserting his Jewish identity and beliefs. The map on the wall symbolizes a door to the future and is his hope against hope in the shadow of death. Self-portrait with Jewish identity card became one of his most famous paintings, when it was showcased in exhibitions in the 90s. The identity card says Jew in two languages, Dutch and French. As a human being, he is not judged by his virtues or character, but by the mere fact that he is Jewish and the Star of David is enough to end his life. His expression is alert and his gaze is confrontational. What does it mean to us as viewers? Is it a conspiratorial gaze, asking us to help keep the secret of his Jewish identity? Is it the gaze of the accuser, demanding from the viewer answers as to why he has been allowed to be so humiliated and persecuted? Is this the terrified face his persecutors will see when he is eventually arrested in July 1944? Beyond the wall, there is a standing limbless tree, a symbol in Jewish funerary art of a life cut short, and in Nussbaum's art, a symbol of melancholy, hopelessness, and death. A dark cloud floats in the lower sky. In the midst of this despair, there is a blossoming bud near the limbless tree that signifies the quintessential quality of a human being, hope, highlighted with a blue sky behind it. Even in this horrible predicament, Nussbaum holds a glimmer of hope that he and his loved ones would somehow survive. In July 1944, he was betrayed. His wife and Nussbaum were arrested and sent to Mechelen Transit Camp and then to Auschwitz. Both were murdered and all their immediate family members died in the Holocaust. There were 6 million more. The only crime that they had committed against the country of which they were once proud citizens was that they were born Jewish. Some believe that as Nussbaum was a German, he had fairly more chances to survive than the Jews who were citizens of other states. But Nussbaum believed in his religion and did not compromise his identity. As a result, he was killed. If you notice, he signed all his portraits, and that was a testament. I was here. I was a fellow human being. I mattered. What is the most gut-wrenching story you have heard about the Nazis? Do let me know in the comment section. If you like what you see, hit the bell icon and subscribe to my channel Frame of Reference, where I upload weekly videos on art, culture, and history. If you like my work, please donate to me on Patreon. And don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends.